Okay, we've looked at the means and the medians, independent and dependent. So now let's take a look at proportions. Suppose I have two different groups and I want to compare the proportions. We're going to do this in two methods. First is the proportions, and then probably in a separate video, I'll do the odds ratios. Now the data types applicable is nominal. This only makes sense for nominal data. Now completing the hypothesis test for the difference of proportions is an awful lot like doing a hypothesis test for a single proportion, only doing it twice. By twice, I'm really making reference to the assumptions. The process is almost identical to what we did. Just like in the means, when we compared two means using a t-test, they both had to be normal or the CLT applied to both. It's the exact same idea here. Only obviously with proportions, the idea of the data being normal makes no sense, but we do need proportions to be normal. Okay, so let's just jump into this one example. A recent survey of 273 men and 291 women resulted in 192 men and 214 women being in favor of changing the college from a semester system to a quarter system. Is there evidence to suggest more women are in favor of the change than are men? So the assumptions are going to be that p hat men is distributed normal, and p hat women are distributed normal. They both need to be distributed normal. Now the assumptions are going to be reasonable if n, I'm going to write this generically first, n1 times p hat 1 has to be at least 5, and n1 times p hat, whoops, let me see, I need to fix that, sorry. n1 times 1 minus p hat 1 has to be at least 5. Now, this is exactly what we saw with one sample, right? Only we didn't have subscripts because we only had one sample. And we also need n2 times p hat 2 to be at least 5, and n2 times 1 minus p hat 2 to be at least 5. If both of these work, or both of these are satisfied, then we can say this is a reasonable assumption. This is applying the CLT to the proportions twice. Now here I don't have 1 and 2. I'm going to change this to min and grab my eraser, and this 2 is going to go away, and I'm going to make this women. So again, you can't just say this. You need to actually check it. So for the men, the number of men, which was 273 times p hat, that's going to be 273 times 192 over 273. Obviously, that cancels. That's 192, clearly greater than or equal to 5. And then the 273 times 1 minus 192 over 273, that's going to be the same as 273 minus 192, which is what, 81? And that's also clearly greater than or equal to 5, so I'm okay for the men. Now, when you do the same for the women, I'm not going to do it here. You can do it, piece of cake. You would get these, well, different numbers, but clearly they're both greater than 5, so check, we're good to go. So let's complete the hypothesis test. The null hypothesis is going to be that pi of the women is equal to pi, the proportion of men. The alternative hypothesis is that pi of the women, the proportion of women, is greater than the proportion of men. And I'm going to let alpha equal 0.05. Now I'm going to rewrite this just as I did with the means. This is equivalent to saying that the proportion of women minus the proportion of men is equal to 0. This is the form that's in TC stats, but these are equivalent. And this is equivalent to saying the proportion of women minus the proportion of men is greater than 0. These are equivalent, so pick whatever one that makes more sense to you. But like I said, this is the form that's in TC stats. So we address the assumptions, and we're ready to go and actually complete the hypothesis test. So in TC stats, I will select analysis methods without data. And I'm dealing with two samples. And this is a two sample Z for proportions. And here I'm already set up 1 minus 2, so I'm going to make that equal. If I wanted a confidence level or confidence interval, I'll put in the confidence level up there. I do want greater. So I need the sample proportions, and the order here has to match the order I have up here. So with 1 minus 2, this is actually women minus men. So first I need to put in the sample proportion for the women. This is 214 over 291. Now, if this was presented to me in the form of a decimal value, then I would put in the decimal value here and the sample size. It would need n. But because I actually have it as a ratio, that's all I'm going to put in. And then likewise, I need to enter the information for the men, which is 192 over 273. And again, it's extremely important to make sure that these match. This first one is the women, which is actually number one, based on the way I wrote my null alternative hypothesis. The second is the men, which matches number two, based on the way I wrote the null alternative hypothesis. So I will update, and then I have a p-value of 0.1981. So clearly I would fail to reject. And for my students, I'm going to want to see all of this. Z is actually equal to 0.8483. Remember, this is a Z value, so being less than one standard deviation away, well, you know that's going to be a big p-value, so that the result doesn't surprise you. The p-value was 0.1981. You don't need the first sample and second sample proportion. Actually, you should. I take that back. I do want that. I want p hat for the women, which is 0.1981. That helped me know that you entered the data right. And p hat for the men, which was, oops, I wrote down the wrong number there. Let me fix that. I wrote the p value down, not the sample proportion. This is 0.7354. And this is 0.7033. Again, this tells me that you actually entered the proper numbers. And then based on this p-value, you would fail to reject, and you would make the statement, there is not enough evidence to suggest the proportion of women is greater than men who want the change in, I'll say semester. So there's the English conclusion.